Don't pull a mountain flowing in this place. Don't fall asleep. Don't let anybody distract you. Praise the name of God. I have told them in our church here, if you are worshiping God, you are praising and doing your thing with your God, anybody that taps you, just this is not the time. And continue. Praise God. Because 2017 you must not be distracted. Hallelujah. So God bless you, sir. Welcome. We thank God for the grace of God upon your life. We're here, we're enjoying God, and we want to say thank you for the vision that you carried on with RCCG in birthing this church. Praise the name of the Lord. And of course, I'm going to wait before I talk about Pastor Umi. Let me wait. So let me just welcome you once again. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. RCCG Treasure House, as you have heard, is a unique church. It's a strange church. Praise the name of God.
Hallelujah.
It's strange because our God performs strange acts in our midst. He has done unbelievable things. We have heard his story when it was read by our brother Kachi. It was just, I was hearing it for the first time, by the way. Praise God. That should tell you about the strength of this church. I did not write it. I did not. I said to people, I just show up in Treasure House. The brethren, they take care of things. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, I just want to point out one or two things. I think Sister Liz will bear me witness that someone, apart from our, I'm mentioning her particularly, because she came the day of the inauguration. She had, praise the name of the Lord. Apparently she has been praying and telling God that where is redeem in this town? And she went to the town center and somebody gave her a leaflet that redeem was about to start. And she showed up at the inauguration and she's still here. Praise the name of the Lord. We honor God for you. Now, one thing I love truly, amongst other things, about these ministers is their ability to tell the truth. Do you understand? That if I do anything or if I've manifested, praise Jesus, at least one of them. Hello, mommy. I don't know today. I'll tell them I haven't started. Praise the name of the Lord. But it's the ability to sit down at meetings and everybody, people say, this is what, I recently had a chat with one of them. I said, what's your problem? I've seen the way you are doing, what's your problem? He said, I assume you. I said, I did. I said, go and sit down somewhere. Let's go. And that is the spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. And I pray that this spirit, this grace will come upon the children of God in Jesus' name. And to the entire Treasure House of God, God bless you. Thank you. Let's we have just been there, irrespective of what. So we want to say thank you. And some of them are shy. Don't mind them. They are shy. Some of them are not shy. Some are thinking right now, why on earth did she call us out? I want people to see you. So when they see you outside, they can say hello. And thank God for God's faithfulness over your lives. Thank you so much. God bless you. The enemy tried, tried, but up until some days ago, tried, but God is faithful because he has prepared a vessel that we use for us. Amen. Now, I mentioned Sister Lisa there because someone actually came when we started the parish here to the weekly meeting and said they came to find out if it were so that there's a church here and that we have been here for weeks. We were at the weekly meeting, we're looking at the person. You bear me witness, Sister Liz. We thought they came to join us. Said, no, I came to find out who are you people? Said, because there's no church that comes to this building that stands. He said, if they bring a lot of people in, they will leave with one member or two members. He said, but you have been here, and I keep hearing that they are, you know, they are increased and they are here. He said, so I came to check, who are you? So we gave them the information we are Redeemed Christian Church of God. And wherever we enter to, Christ takes over. Amen. Because we're not the ones doing the work, it is God that is doing the work. And so you are here to celebrate with a good thing. 10 years on, we're still here. I mean, there was a fellowship. We did not know because they didn't tell us. So by the time we started digging, we discovered that a guy that comes, you know, is it the on Sundays or something? Apparently, it was a church, but it was only him and sometimes another person that would come because the guy refused. If I remember correctly, that he was about to pack and leave, but when he saw that we were here and where God was increasing his church, he decided to stay put there. Even if it's me and this one person, we will continue. Until some years later, he was himself alone, he decided to leave. So many churches have come to this building. Pastor, so many. I mean, we were in church one day, we found one carrying our pulpit and carrying it. Where are you taking it? He said, they are in church. Before we could leave, they leave. They can't stay. They will come, they will leave. But God has been faithful. God has been faithful to us. Praise the name of God. And I always encourage the church, don't look at numbers, just look that God daily adds to our numbers. The second thing I want to mention from the story so far that was read was we're having a weekly meeting. The door was shut, so I told you it's a strange church. So we decided to have a service on the stairs and in the balcony. So we were there and there were some about 11, 13 children that they know all over this town as a really, you know, they are children from wealthy homes, you know, and all that, but they just come and manifest. I'm sure you were there that day, Minister Adi. They set the bin on fire, opened the lift, and you know, through it, there was nothing they didn't do. I told the brother, I said, keep on praising God and keep on praying. We were there, then one of them took his phone and started videoing us. I said, he's going to post it on YouTube, making fun of us. They will come in front of people praying. They will go, hee, 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 hee. About almost 13 of them. I mean, not really, you know, if they slap me, I'll just beg them. You know, that kind of thing. But then all of a sudden, the Holy Spirit just said, sing a song. And we started singing. And all of a sudden, the leader, the capote, the kingpin, just came. And came and looked at us, you know, came up the stairs, they were looking, and then sat down and was just looking. And then all of a sudden, he started calling all of them, stop what you are doing. Keep quiet, stop what you are doing. And by the time we finished that day, at least about 11 of them accepted Christ.
Amen.
Praise the name of God. And I was so glad because one of them now called me and said they wanted to, you know, they can't talk to their mother, they've never seen her before. I said, listen, I'm pregnant and I want to go and commit abortion. But from what I've heard today, I'm changing. So what do I do? I mean, people will never. So God is God in our midst. He is faithful to save. So I just want to thank God for those who have started with us, those who have joined us along the way, that God will prove himself in your life.
Amen.
And you will never be put to shame.
Amen.
And God, that is the God of Redeemed Christian Church of God, will give you divine surprises.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So we thank you, we bless the name of the Lord for your lives, for coming to celebrate with us. God bless you indeed.
Amen.
Now, God bless you. Thank you, Minister. Are we going to pass up and pray for the church later? So pray for all of us, and I know God will answer his prayers as he has always done in Jesus' name. Now, Pastor Wumiola Dujoye, I called her. When I got, you know, the text about, you know, Pastor Jetty Kalejai not being able to make it, I said, God, who have you prepared? Who should I call? My mind just went, you know, blank. But even my husband said to me, what are you going to do? make sure time, you know, before the time runs away from us, I know. And all of a sudden, I had in my spirit, I should call Pastor Wu. So I said, okay. So I picked the phone, I called her, I explained what happened to her. You know, some other pastor might think, oh, you didn't call me in the beginning, why are you calling me now? But she said, oh, okay. He said, I'm supposed to be in Norwich. And then, you know, along with things just started working together. You know, even yesterday, we're still on the phone. I mean, she ministered at the pastor's retreat this morning. And you can imagine, and yet still able to put all several things aside to come and be a blessing to us. We just want to say thank you. We appreciate you. Thank you so much. Continue to honor you in Jesus' name. I've known Pastor Wu for over 25 years. I think it was Pastor Janet that told me some 3 years ago. He said, you this woman, come. I've known you for 25 years. Even 25 year old married, they should have divorced by now. He said, but you are still, I will still greet you, you will greet me. Ah, do both of us have problems? We don't have problems, but we understand each other and we relate well. Pastor, may God is using her and we continue to use her. But she's a provincial pastor in the Redeemed Christian, the first female pastor to start a church in RCCG. Praise the name of God. Use that to pray protocol. Praise the name of the Lord. She's a member of the trustee of RCCG UK. She's a wonderful woman of God, the senior pastor of Holy Ghost Zone. Praise the name of the Lord. So right now, you know MLEs, but because she's here now for the first time in how many years? Ah, Lord have mercy. Holy Ghost Zone now is zoned here now. Praise God. Praise the name of the Lord. She's married to our father, the Lord Prince Oladunjoye. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And she's she has children, grandchildren. She's the president of Divine Encounter Program, and every day she leads prayers on phone. For she's been doing that for so many years. Before it became well known, she's been doing it. And I just want you to make welcome. And she's my friend. Praise the name of the Lord. I thought we'd clap for that. Let me tell the woman of the mighty God.
God is good. That before the foundations of the world, God had purposed that we will all be here today.
Amen.
Because for children of God, nothing happens by coincidence. This is God's incidence. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the reason why God has brought all of us together this evening shall be fulfilled in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you. You may be seated in His presence. I want to say happy anniversary to Treasure House. Congratulations to Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Shegu. It's not easy to gather even 4 people together for a month. Talk less of 10 years. It's not easy. It can only be God. And we have listened to the testimonies of the harassment of hell against this church. But you know, Jesus said, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. The person who had the audacity to come and say, why is your own different? You've been chasing people away. Why is your own different? It is because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The child of the king has been sent here, has been commissioned here to come and take over the king's property. And there is no power. No power. No power that can chase the children of God away. We give God all the glory. Like she said, it's not by numbers. It's not. It's not by numbers. The Almighty God has been doing His work in your life or in your lives. He will continue to do it. He will take you from glory to glory. In the mighty name of Jesus. I congratulate you once again. And I pray that you will celebrate many, many, many more anniversaries. In the mighty name of Jesus. And at the end, you will not miss heaven. Because that is the greatest achievement of man. To spend eternity with God. Whatever will not allow you to make heaven, God will remove it from you. In the mighty name of Jesus. This evening, we're going to be sharing the word of God. And the topic I've been given to speak on is the next level. The next level. And the scripture that was given to me is Deuteronomy chapter 1. And I want to read from verse 6 to 8. Father, we just bless and wonders that you have been doing in the midst of your people. Thank you, Lord God, for 10 years of your faithfulness. Lord, be exalted in the name of Jesus. Father, even as we approach your word this evening, we approach with reverence. We pray, Lord God Almighty, that the power in your word, Lord God Almighty, will set us free. In the name of Jesus. Your word will make our lives better. Your word will take us from glory to glory. Your word will do us good. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 1, I'll read from verse 6 to 8. It says, the Lord our God spake unto us in Horeb, saying, ye have dwelt long enough in this land. Turn you and take your journey, and go to the mountain of the Amorites and unto the places near thereunto, in the plain, in the hills, and in the vale, and in the south, and by the seaside, to the land of Canaanites, and unto Lebanon, unto the great river, the river Euphrates. Behold, I have set the land before you. Go in and possess the land which the Lord sware unto your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give unto them and to their seed after them. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the God that we serve is a progressive God. He is limitless by nature. Nobody can limit him. He's a progressive God. And he doesn't want his children to be limited. He doesn't want his children to be stagnant. In the scripture that we read, God was telling the leader, Moses, to advance to the next level. Because that is the summary of the scripture that I've read. That is, move on. Advance. He said, you have stayed too long on this mountain. Get going. Move on to the next level. And God is saying the same thing to you in this church. God is calling you to break free from every limitation. Tell your neighbor, God wants you to break free from every limitation. He wants you to move on to the next level. So whatever has been hindering your move to the next level, whatever has been limiting your progress, whatever has cast limitation upon your life must be destroyed.
Amen.
And it shall be destroyed by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You see, the life of man is subject to limitations, and it takes the power of the Holy Ghost to remove such limitations. The Bible tells us in Zechariah chapter 4, verses 6 and 7. Zechariah 4, 6 and 7, I'm reading from the New Living Translation. The Bible says, then he said to me, this is what the Lord says to you.
So God is saying that it is not by force, it is not by strength that limitations can be removed. It is by the Spirit of God. And every mountain that is standing as a hindrance to your breakthrough shall become a level plain.
Amen.
Before you.
Amen.
By the power of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Every mountain that is saying you are not going to advance, that you are not going to move forward, that you are not going to progress, the power of the Holy Ghost will approach that mountain.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost is the Spirit of the Almighty God. He's the third person of the Trinity. He's the power of God. And God cannot do anything without his Spirit.
It was
answer now. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Then Peter said, silver and gold have I none. But such as I have given thee, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he, leaping up, stood and walked. And every time he left into the arms at the beautiful gate of the temple, and they were filled with wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. And as a lame man which was healed held Peter and John, all the people ran together unto them in the porch that is called Solomon's, greatly wondering. Brethren, in this account we see the manifestation of the Holy Ghost in the lives of Peter and John. The Bible says that they went to the temple at the hour of prayer, and through them the power of the Holy Ghost destroyed the yoke of limitation from the life of that lame man. And I want to prophesy to you today that the power of the Holy Ghost will come upon you.
Amen.
He will remove every limitation from you.
Amen.
He will grant you breakthrough.
Amen.
Your life will move forward.
Amen.
You will progress.
Amen.
You will advance.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will move to the next level.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This lame man is right from his mother's womb. His life had been subject to serious limitation right from the time that he was born. He had never used his legs before, not even for one day. All his life he had been used to being carried by others. I want you to imagine such a life. As a baby, he was carried. As a toddler, he was carried. As a young boy, he was carried. As a teenager, he was carried. Even as an adult, he was carried. Because he was born lame right from his mother's womb. Never he breaks through by the operation of the Holy Ghost power in the lives of Peter and John. Amen.
Amen.
And so tonight, the power of the Holy Ghost will work on your behalf.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The unexpected, the unexplainable
Amen.
Breakthrough
Amen.
Will happen in your life.
Amen.
You will mark it that on the 10th anniversary celebration of Treasure House, something Amen. Happened to my life.
Amen.
Something good.
Amen.
I want you to raise your hand to the Lord. Say,
oh Lord,
release upon me
release upon
the anointing of your Holy Ghost. And let the unexpected and the unexplainable breakthrough happen in my life. In the name of Jesus, go ahead and pray for yourself. Let the unexpected and unexplainable breakthrough. So shall it be. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Now, before his encounter with the power of God, the only work that this lame man knew to do was begging for alms. That was the only work. That was his profession. Because he was limited. His mindset had been programmed to live on alms. Nothing more, nothing less. His prayer was always that he will meet benevolent and generous people that will give him alms. That was his prayer. However, on this fateful day, he received a breakthrough. God gave him more than he bargained for. This lame man was looking for something that will sustain him in his condition. Remember, his condition was limited. He was always being carried. They would carry him, put him at the gate. And when he closed for work, they would come and carry him again back home. That was his life. And he was always looking. You will receive breakthrough on every side.
Amen.
Everything that has limited your life shall be no more.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
When the lame man begged for upon your life,
yeah.
so that you will begin to do what you ought to have been doing,
Amen.
Which you have not done before.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, the second significant thing that was always being put at the gate, it was limited to the gate. He couldn't enter. Because those who had mercy on him, who brought him daily to the temple, they always dumped him at the gate. But when the miracle happened, when the power of the Holy Ghost removed the limitation from his life, this man that had been sitting by the gate of the temple for so many years, this man that had never had the opportunity to enter into the temple because of his limitation, had an encounter with the power of the Holy Ghost, and that encounter gave him access into the place that he never had access to before. And I want to prophesy tonight that the power of the Holy Ghost will give somebody a breakthrough.
Amen.
If you are that person, I want you to say a better amen.
Amen.
I said the power of the Holy Ghost will give you a breakthrough.
Amen.
God is going to grant you access
Amen.
Into places you never ever dreamt you can enter.
Amen.
Places you don't ever think that you can enter. If they say you will enter Buckingham Palace to have dinner with a queen, you say, who, me? But the power of God can do it.
Yes.
So don't limit your God. Because he's unlimited.
Yes.
Don't let your mindset put a limitation on your life. To say, these preachers, they have come again with their sweet mouths. How can I, this little me, have a dinner with the queen in the Buckingham Palace? How can that be possible? It is not by might. It's not by power. But by my spirit. That man never ever dreamt that he could enter the temple. He did not have access to the temple because of his limitation. But the power of God removed that limitation and he had access. With his two legs, he walked into the temple. Somebody, you are going to get access into the high places. In the name of Jesus. You have dwelt on this mountain long enough. You are moving forward. In the mighty name of Jesus. Still looking at verse 8. The Bible says, and he entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping. When this man received his breakthrough, he did not run off with the breakthrough. He entered with Peter and John into the temple to pray. When God demonstrates his power in your life, you need to pray. Some people, as soon as they receive their breakthrough, they will say goodbye to the house of God. As soon as they get what they want from the Lord, they will begin to give one excuse or the other why they cannot come to church again to worship God. To worship the one who gave them the breakthrough. I want you to pray. Say in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord. Regardless of the breakthrough I receive from you. Help me to continue to worship you. To continue to serve you. Go ahead and pray. Because God is going to give you anniversary gifts. When he gives you that pain, tell him, Lord, don't let me abandon you. Don't let me begin to give excuses. I don't want to begin to give excuses why I cannot serve you, I cannot worship you again. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, the third significant thing that this man did in that verse 8, the Bible says, I'm praising God. He said, he entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. This ex-lame man was so grateful to God. And he showed his gratitude by praising the Lord. And I want to prophesy to you that beginning from tonight, you will have plenty of reasons to praise the Lord. You will praise God continually throughout this year 2017 and all the days of your life. You will have reasons to praise the Lord. It will be breakthrough upon breakthrough, progress upon progress, advancement upon advancement in the name of Jesus. Tonight we are going to ask God to release his Holy Ghost power upon us as he did in the lives of the disciples in Acts chapter 2. Maybe we should read Acts chapter 2 from verse 1 to 4. The Bible says, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. It was after this particular encounter, that Peter and John went to the temple to pray, and they saw the lame man, and the power of God upon their lives removed the limitation from the life of this lame man. Amen. Verse 3 says, there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and he sat on each of them, and they were filled with the Holy Ghost, And they began to speak in other tongues. Ladies and gentlemen, I want us to welcome the Holy Ghost. Because whatever limitation that is in your life, whatever has not allowed you to go to the next level, whatever has not allowed you to move forward, to advance, whatever has not allowed you to be where your contemporaries are, it is the power of the Holy Ghost that can deal with it. So I want us to rise up. I want us to welcome the Holy Ghost. Let's welcome Him. Because when He comes and takes over our lives, just as He did to that lame man, we all will be sorted. Welcome, welcome, welcome. To the Lord. Say in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, come upon me tonight. Make my life whole. Destroy every yoke of limitation. Grant me breakthroughs on every side so that I can move to the next level. In the name of Jesus. Go ahead and pray for yourself. Pray for yourself tonight. I call upon you tonight. Come upon me, O God. Remove every yoke of limitation. From now on, let me move forward. Whatever limitation that I've been in my life, even right from my mother's womb, deal with it tonight. Make my life to move forward. Make me to advance. That from tonight you are moving forward. I want you to shout the loudest hallelujah.